morning children, how are you all? Hope you all are fine. I am your grade 4 English teacher. Right, today is date 9-12-2020. We are doing block 16, once in a village. Our topic today is S3, text to word connection. What do you mean by text to word connection? It is nothing but what story we are reading, that how it is related to, how it is connected to the world or real life. See here, today we will learn to connect the details in the story to real world children. We have read this story children, once in a village. What you have studied, that all the people in the village, they have cut down the trees. What happened, since 5 years there was no rainfall. Then what happened, they started praying. At last they got rainfall. This we have studied in this story too. So, how it is connected? This story, how it is connected to the real world? Real world means where we all are living too. See, you can see here, teacher. This is known as teacher. Not drinking tea, children. This is T-shaped char. See, what it is there here? What the story says? What it reminds me of? Means what? What the story says? How the problem started, what happened, how it started, when it happened, where it happened, and how it solved. Next one, what it reminds me of. What it is reminding you, children? The story is telling you something, it is passing you some message. And you should connect that message to the real world. What it is passing message to you all? The story is telling you that today in our life, real world, real life, what we all are doing? We are cutting down many trees to build roads, factories and houses. What will happen to us? We are predicting now. What will happen to us if we are going to cut down the trees like this? What happened in the story? There was no rainfall. So, when we are connecting the story to the real life, in future we may not get rainfall and there will be no water to drink. No? So, this may happen. This we are relating to. We are connecting here to the teacher children. What the story says, what it reminds me of. Now let us do a workbook. Children, see, take out your workbook. Page number 42, S3, text to word connection. Next, write today's date 9-12-2020. See, children, there is a T-chart. See, read the key details of the story in a table. What do they remind you of from the real world? Write one example for each key details. He gave you here what the story says. These are key details. He gave you what the story will say. You should write here what it remind me of. Means what it remind you of. Okay children, see, first one I have did for you. Remaining two you write better. Next, now what you can think, how can I write here? You think what you know and write here. See here, first one, what the story says, what it remind me of. The number of people in the village was increasing and they need houses and fields. So they began to cut down the trees. What it remind me of. See, I was writing what it remind me of when I was in Bangalore. See, the city of Bangalore had few houses and people lived in the village in this story. It remind me of Bangalore children. When I was in Bangalore, when I was small, I was in Bangalore children. In Bangalore, there are many trees. Now, the number of trees have decreased. When I was small, there was many trees children. And there was no need to on the fan also when you are in Bangalore. But now, every house has fan children. In Bangalore, I am talking about. See, the city of Bangalore had few houses and people. And people in the village in the story also have few houses, children. As people came to city looking for jobs, the number of people increased. People cut down the trees to make roads. Children, everyone now started going and living and working in the Bangalore, children. So what happened? Due to this, they are cutting many trees, children. So it remind me about this story, children, how they started cutting down the trees. Here, I took the example of Bangalore because I know about Bangalore. So in Bangalore, there was many trees. Now, there are less trees comparing to
that period. Why? Because everyone are getting jobs in Bangalore. They are going and living there. When people are increasing, number of houses and roads should increase. They should make. So number of trees are cut. Next one, what you should write? By the 4 years, the grass became brown, the ponds dried up and the lotus died. What it remind you of? You write here. Everyone lifted their hands up, sang and danced with the rain when the rain came. What it remind you of? You write here, children. Next, give proofs for what it remind me of with the help of either a picture, a newspaper article or a... Children, this you should actually do in activity in your classwork. But now we are not having any class. Now we are not doing any classwork, no? So let us write this as a proof. He's telling you to go and ask and write here. What you'll ask and write here? Ask some person how it was compared from those days to these days. For example, see, I have written here. I spoke to the gardener. He said that 20 years ago, there was 250 trees in the park. And today, we have only 50 remained. Means, there is a gardener proof. You went and you did inquiry. No picture, no need of keeping picture here. Okay, so you write here like this. Or you can ask someone, you can ask your mummy, daddy, grandmother, grandfather. They'll explain you nicely. Before 40 years back, 30 years back, 20 years back, there was many trees here. Okay, they'll tell, no, how it has changed now. Now there is a shopping mall here. So write that here. Seeing this, okay. Understood, children? Hope you all understood. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.